All right, we're going to get started in about a minute. All right, if we can bring everyone back to your seating area, please. All right. I just want to first just do another acknowledgement of all of the winners that we just celebrated. So let's just give another round of applause for everyone, because that's amazing. I also want to give a round of applause to our caterers. Have you guys enjoyed this food like I have? Amazing. All right, we have been through quite a journey today, right? We explored values for the organization, which, as a recap, growth, learning, excellence, belonging. We heard an amazing keynote from Janice, right? And we talked about all the work that she's doing to bring into the world and what she's doing to continue to elevate voice and do the leadership development work that you do. Thank you, thank you, thank you for the industry, for the profession. We've celebrated our fellows and our scholarship. So we've done a lot today. We had a lot of conversation today at different tables that was led by A3K around the values and how we want to bring those to life in the initiatives and the projects and the new chapters of AWA plus D to enliven those values. So in the interest of sort of looking back through our day, right, because it's easy to kind of live moment to moment, and then we go on, and it's Saturday night, we've got plans, and then what happened, what, where, what, who? I invite us to take a moment, if you've got a pen and paper in front of you. I have a morning practice. Does anyone have a morning practice? It could be anything. Yeah, my morning practice, I wake up at 5:30, I grab coffee, I sit in my office while the coffee's still brewing, I meditate, I journal, and I've learned a practice in the last year that from a peer of mine, another friend of mine who uses applied improv in her work, and she taught it to me as a gratitude reflection, and I want to share it with you as a takeaway today, but also to sit with us. We'll just sit here in silence for a couple of minutes, and maybe we can invite you to use it as a reflection point for where we've come today and potentially where we're headed. And it's called the GLAD technique, G-L-A-D. The G is, what are you grateful for? What is one, maybe two things that you're grateful for? So in the context of today, what are you grateful for about your time together? Maybe the people you've met, the experiences that you've had so far today. L is, what have you learned? I'm sure there are many things that you've learned today and that you will continue to learn as you explore after today and take with you what all the things that we've discussed and explored. That's L. A is something that you've accomplished. Is there something that you've accomplished today? And maybe that's using your voice, pitching your business in a way to somebody you've never met before, in a way you've never done before. So it could be something small or something big. Accomplished, A. And the D is delighted. What did you delight in today? Was there a moment where you had a conversation with someone, an exchange of some sort, an idea, something you wrote down that you're going to take back to your partners or other people that are helping you manage your business or bringing your own work to life? G-L-A-D, gratitude, learned, accomplished, delighted. And I'll just shush for a minute here and invite you to write down a couple things that might come to you. Just give us about maybe 30 more seconds. Okay, if you're still writing, continue to write. That's a gift that you've just given to yourself, okay? Keep it with your notes, put it in the notebook that you have with you. And I also invite you, if you've met someone here today that you've said, let's talk, here's my card, let's chat, let's get together, let's have a coffee, bring that with you. Maybe it's a way that you can inspire additional conversation and build on what we've done today. GLAD, what was inspiring about today that you want to honor now and then potentially bring forward that might incite additional exploration for you and with someone that you've met. Okay. That was a reflection piece of our kind of, I think Meg called it the wake-up session. And the reason it's called a wake-up session is because we're going to do something right now that's going to hopefully inspire a little wakefulness. My company's name is Enlivened Studios, and this is an opportunity for us to, what I say, enliven up. So there is a man called Keith Johnstone. Keith Johnstone is sort of the granddaddy of improvisational theater. He's a Canadian. He passed away in the last couple of years, and he has a bunch of quotes that are just amazing about yes and all the things that we've talked about in the morning session. And one of them that I love is he says that adults are just atrophied children. Right? We grow up and we say, we don't play anymore because that's too juvenile and we have to be professionals. Well, guess what? Play does all sorts of amazing things to the parts of your brain that inspire creativity and the juices and make change and spontaneity and kind of get you to live off script a little bit, right? Sometimes we feel like we have to be so scripted. So this is an opportunity for us to play, because what we're going to do now, and it does involve getting up and moving our bodies a little bit, is we are going to have, among all of us, a rock, paper, scissors tournament. Okay, but here's the trick. So rock, paper, scissors, if anyone needs a reminder, this is the symbol for rock, this is the symbol for paper, and this is the symbol for scissors. Okay? Scissors trumps paper, because you cut paper. Paper trumps rock, because the idea is rock can cover on top, or paper can cover on top of a rock. And then rock trumps scissors. Does that make sense? Does everybody need it? Okay, cool, cool, cool. All right, that's rock, paper, scissors. So what we're going to do is you're just going to find a partner next to you and start doing rock, paper, scissors. One, two, three, right? One, two, three, whatever. Everybody knows how that goes. Okay. Now, here's the thing that we're going to do, and this is where make your partner look good really comes into play. The loser of the rock, paper, scissors becomes the winner's cheerleader and follows that person to their next opponent. So if you and I just met, but I forgot your name. Me. If Nee and I were partners, we would go rock, paper, scissors. I would be the winner, right? Nee is the loser, air quotes loser. But she now becomes my cheerleader, and we go over here, and now we play rock, paper, scissors. I am still the winner, apparently. Now I have two cheerleaders. So we walk around with this posse of cheerleaders. Okay, so that's how this goes, because there are no losers in this game, okay? And so there's going to be people walking around cheering. And when I say cheerleader, you're like, go, 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 woo! Okay, let's just kind of move our bodies a little bit, use our voices. And ultimately, we're going to come down to two people. And whoever wins that gets bragging rights for having won rock, paper, scissors at symposium. Does that sound like everybody makes sense, everybody? Yes.
So, if you lose, your entourage goes with you.
If you lose, you are part of an entourage that follows the winner to their next opponent.
A big line of...
Sure. It'll be a big line of cheerleaders. Ultimately, it's a lot of cheerleaders, and one person's going to win, and the whole room's going to celebrate that one person. Okay? It's going to feel really great. I promise. This is play. Remember play? All right. So, and if anybody feel, if let's just partner up, and if someone doesn't have a partner, give a raise your hand, and I'm happy to be your partner. So turn to somebody, and if you don't have a friend, let me know. Oh, and yeah, if it doesn't have to be at your table. You can get up and move around to other tables if you need a partner. Move around the whole room, the whole room. You can do three, sure, yeah. Move around the whole room. Are we doing the last one? Do we have one more?
Right here, right here. Right here.
We have a winner. We have a winner. Woo, 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 woo. Way to go, Christina. Let's give a round of applause to Christina for winning rock, paper, scissors. I have a confession to make. I just told this to Janice. I've never done that before. I've never led that exercise before. So let this be maybe an inspiration. I mean, not that I need any to incite any inspiration, but there's another improv tenet, which is start anywhere. Not everything needs, well, in your line of work, certainly things do need to come one before the other, of course, because sometimes we need very exact calculation. Other times, not everything's going to be perfect, and we haven't done it before, and we do it anyway, because if we don't do it, especially as women in your profession, start anywhere. Just start. because we need you to do the work in this world. We need your voice. We need the work that you're doing. We need the connection and the engagement and the relationships that you're building. And sometimes you don't know what's going to happen when you try something for the first time. And sometimes it ends up being kind of fun. Yes? Anyway, thank you for playing. That is my afternoon wake-up activity. Congratulations again to Christina. I'm going to pass this off to Katarina. Oh, no, sorry, to Ashley. Thanks, everyone. Oh, can I make one more? I just wanted to remind everyone, we had a three-part virtual well-being series. The first two sessions have passed. There's a third session on June 6th, which is this coming week. I facilitate it, but it's much more about the genius in the room. We have great conversation about time management, tips and tricks for how to make sure that we're managing our boundaries and our wellness in this profession, both personally, professionally. And this coming week is going to be a recap of what we've done today. So that's really the focus of that session. It's on June 6th. The information is on the website. You can register there. It's an hour. It's at 10 o'clock, 10:30 in the morning on the 6th. And you don't have to have come to the first two to come to the third. So if you feel inspired, please join us on that. We'll have another opportunity to gather and talk about everything that happened today.